am Ms. Griffin, the super blessed assistant principal of South Columbus Elementary School.
And welcome to today's show.
And it looks like we are sunny at South Columbus, so let's talk about the weather.
We are sunny today, but extremely cold once again. Very, very cold once again. It was very cold this morning
it
in
was.
The low 20s. We're going to get up a little higher than we did yesterday, though, 58 degrees. I don't think the wind chill is going to be as bad as it was yesterday. And
oh,
we're definitely going to see more sunshine today.
Yay.
Looking ahead for tomorrow, we have got a little warmer.
I think so.
61 degrees is going to be the high, but it is supposed to rain. I think the rain is supposed to start. We're supposed to have a thunderstorm pretty badly tonight, starting tonight, and then
no.
tomorrow it's going to be raining pretty much.
Okay. Well, at least we know. So prepare. Make sure you wear your rain jackets, your galoshes, your cute rain boots, and if you need an emergency poncho, make sure you go to the guidance office and see Miss Wallace.
We've got you.
And for lunch today, Miss Bigelow and the crew. Oh my gosh, I think this is one of my favorite meals. Today we are having ham and cheese sandwich. I love a good ham and cheese sandwich. Glazed carrots, fruit milk, and as always, teachers, please get your lunch counts in by 9 o'clock so they can prepare adequately. And if you are a virtual student or parent watching, remember we serve grab and goes on the South Lumpkin side of the building between 11 and 11:45, and you also get breakfast for the next day. So support our school nutrition program, and we appreciate it. Well, today is Witty Wednesday.
Wednesday. Woo woo.
And I believe you have a joke.
I do. And I think it's quite witty.
I believe it. Okay. So let's see. Let's hear it.
All right. Now, remember, we like to see your comments, your response. So if you know the answer, feel free to respond.
We're going to give them some wait time, too.
We are going to give you some wait time. And
good.
This is Ms. Jenkins' favorite because it revolves around math.
Math teacher. Mm-hmm. Hashtag.
All right. Listen up. What did one math book say to the other?
We need our Jeopardy music.
3, 2, 1. Ready?
Yes. What did he say?
Don't bother me. I've got problems of my own.
A math book. It's got problems.
There you go. Witty Wednesday.
Got 99 problems, but a math book ain't one. Y'all, I'll crack myself up. Anyways. Okay, don't forget to comment and like and subscribe on our channel. And if you have a joke you want us to air on our broadcast, please submit it to either your teacher or to the office for us to do on Witty Wednesday. So,
you're just cracking up over that. I told you it was going to be really witty.
So we have some birthdays today. We have two very special birthdays. Herval Parker, happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Genesis Ayala Santoyo, happy birthday. I hope this day is as great as you are. And last off, let's talk about our Black History Fact.
Yeah, just a really quick one today about Fort Benning. We're all very familiar with Fort Benning,
right? Local history,
yeah. So Fort Benning, the military base was first established in 1918. And then 2 years later, the first African-American troops were assigned to Fort Benning.
In 1920.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
In 1920.
Well, that's interesting.
And of course, there was still segregation going on at that time. They weren't allowed to have certain jobs.
Right.
But they were still very valuable members serving on base. They were allowed to be what they call watchmen, and they did a lot of other service type jobs, but their biggest contribution was actually the continued construction of the military base. They were very critical in constructing roadways and building like the exchange that's on the base.
Okay.
They had a very impact on directly building that.
I love that
structure.
And that is just right around the corner. I love that bridge. That's
a beautiful part
of Fort Benning. Mm-hmm. Well, I don't think we have anything else. I think that's it for this edition of the Eagle's Nest News. And please remember,
wear your mask, wash your hands, and watch your distance.
And as always, we soar at South Columbus. I am
safe.